Tragedy has struck our town. Two children have been taken recently. The last one disappeared just 3 days ago. The authorities don't know what to do. I beg of you, help us. Sincerely, Alice Thompson.
Detective, the League needs your help with an urgent case. Children are going missing in Blake's Mountain, and signs point to a supernatural cause. Be careful, and hurry. The Red Moon is nearly upon us.
Are you the detective? You have to help us. Someone is in our house. I think they're after my daughter. Oh, please excuse my manners. My name is Alice. I wrote to your people about the two missing children, and now someone is after my Goldie. We need to get to town, but the gates are already closed for the night. I left our key behind in the rush. Help us find the gate key in the house. Can't be happening. Not my Goldie. Please, architect. Find my daughter.
Thank you.
Lakes Mountain is a small provincial town. Its citizens enjoy fun and carefree afternoons. At night, the citizens return home to rest, and the town becomes quiet. But once every 300 years comes a very rare night, the Red Moon. Legend says that during a Red Moon, evil forces become more powerful. They escape to our world and roam the lands, doing their evil deeds. Thank you.
What are you doing here? Get out before you put my son in danger. No! Stay away from him, you monster! You must be the detective we've been expecting. It seems you're too late to help me. Please, don't blame yourself. My magic defenses were not strong enough to stop that creature. But I might have a way to see where it came from. Approach my table. This orb is called the Eye of the Seer. You can see almost anything with its help, if you know how to use it. Let us learn the creature's secret. When I was a girl, a healer lived in our town. She had the ability to cure any illness. Then one day, an awful plague swept through the town, creeping into houses one by one. The healer worked day and night. Her skills saved those who were doomed. But there was one person the healer couldn't save. Her own daughter. Even her amazing powers could not heal the poor little girl. The loss devastated her. The healer became a recluse, avoiding all contact with the town. It can't be. So many years have passed, but the eye showed her face. Could she be involved? It seems a powerful force doesn't want us using the eye. Help me repair it so we can find the missing children. Very good, detective. Now, please take the eye with you. I must stay here and recover from the attack, but we can still communicate through the eye.
Thank you. them.
I've been waiting a long time for this moment. Now I finally have enough children to begin the ritual. As for you, detective, soon you won't be able to disturb my plans anymore. Burn it all!
Detective, is that you? We must learn who's behind the kidnapping. Keep searching. Returning home one evening as a child, I noticed a strange glow around the healer's house. I was a curious girl, and I could not resist approaching. And that's when I saw her, the healer. But she had changed. Suddenly, shadows surrounded me, and I heard wicked laughter. I still don't remember how I escaped and made it home. I told my parents what happened, and soon a crowd of citizens had gathered around the healer's house. Terrified, they broke in and found evidence of sorcery everywhere. But the healer was already gone. No one has seen her since. Once again, the eye shows us the healer. I'm afraid there is only one explanation. The healer is involved in the kidnappings.
Thank you. Miserably. Perhaps it was never here. Perhaps it does not exist. In the end, all I have to my name is this small chest, which I cannot even open. There is nothing left to say but goodbye, Jack.
This is energy produced by powerful memories. The eye can capture such energy and create images. Let's see what this memory tells us.
The girl was slowly dying, consumed by disease, and the healer was powerless to stop it. In desperation, the healer opened a forbidden book, the Book of Dark Magic. A stranger appeared and told the healer there was a way to save her daughter. But she must forsake the light and receive the darkness. The healer agreed without hesitation.
And so it becomes clear. To save her daughter, the healer became an evil witch.
darkness has no place in my forest. Be gone.
Is that so? And just how do you plan to stop it?
Has struck me to the roots, and my trees. The curse has taken them too. They do not hear me. Please remove this sickle. Oh.
Thank you.
friend, will you clean the poison from the wound? I'm afraid the poison has already soaked through me. The only cure is an elixir of life. You must prepare it. Here, take this. Thank you, friend. You will always be welcome in my forest. Now go, and may the forces of nature protect you. The dark stranger presented the Stone of Souls, which could preserve the soul of a dying person. The healer transferred her daughter's soul into the stone. On the night of the Red Moon, the dark stranger explained, the stone would be able to resurrect the soul inside through a special ritual. But he did not mention that there was a condition.
Thank you.
You're so predictable, Detective. It's a common trait of those who end up at the bottom of this swamp.
Thank you.
December 14th. I have learned that the healer who disappeared from this town years ago is connected to the missing hunter and his son. Signs point to dark magic. I must find out what happened. December 15th. The healer had set a trap for me, and I fell right into it. There's no way out of this swamp. The creature who lives here will not allow escape. This looks like the end of my investigation. Detective Gordon. To perform the resurrection ritual, the healer had to master dark magic. She practiced every night, not realizing that it was attracting evil, shadowy creatures that surrounded her house. One evening, a young girl passed by the healer's house and saw what was happening. Realizing that more townsfolk would soon follow, the healer fled her home. Thank you.
Don't cry, little ones. There's nothing to be afraid of. Come along now. Oh, you again. I'm afraid you're too late. Preparations for the ritual are complete. Now no one can stop me. Not even you.
Thank you.
Several years passed, and the night of the Red Moon was approaching. The Dark Stranger came to visit the healer in her new home beyond the forest. He gave her a book that described the resurrection ritual. That is when the healer learned of the terrible condition. To bring back the soul of her daughter, the Soul Stone needed to absorb the souls of four other children. The healer was shocked. But dark magic and her love for her daughter had blinded her. She decided to move forward with the ritual and used her assistant to help her gather the children.
Detective, the moon is blood red. The ritual must begin.
Hello, stranger. That witch has been keeping me here for days. She wants to make me her slave, just like the Scarecrow. But I know how to ruin her plans. She has a special altar of control. You can use it to remove the curse from the Scarecrow. And if you help me, I'll help you in return. Here, you'll need this. freedom. Ha ha! Thank you. Here's the key to the witch's cabinet. The altar is inside, but don't forget, to remove the curse from the scarecrow, you'll need a scarecrow ragdoll. Good luck! This is the altar of control. It will help you lift the curse from the scarecrow, but you don't have much time.
Remember? You need a ragdoll of the Scarecrow to make the altar work.
Don't let that fool interfere! You're too late! There's no stopping me now!
But the Scarecrow only serves me. You'll never remove the curse. It doesn't matter. You'll fail in the end. The ritual must continue. This is impossible. The Scarecrow only serves me.
She did it because she loves me so much. There's no room for me here now. I have to go. Thank you for everything, Detective.